Guten Morgen, ich bin Dan, der Prof von Natürlich, Luxemburgisch with Anne. This lesson is all about the passive voice in Luxemburgisch. So I want to explain to you in an easy way. So why we use the passive voice in Luxemburgisch, when we use it, and how we build a sentence in the passive voice. So, bist du bereit für die Lektion? Dann los! So, let's start with when do we use the passive voice in Luxembourgish? So, we use the passive voice when the writer or speaker wants to put emphasis on the action. So on the object rather than the subject doing something. So the passive voice tells us either it is not important who does something or we just don't know who is doing something. Let's take the example, for example, Gebäude wird renoviert. So I don't know who is renovating the building and it isn't important as well. What is important is that the building is being renovated, okay? Now, in a passive voice sentence, you can include the agent. So the agent is by whom something is being done, or you may not include it. So if you want to include it in Luxembourgish, you will have to build it with a fun phrase. Let's take our example, Gebäude wird renoviert. If you want to say that the building is being renovated by the commune, you will say, Gebäude wird von der Gemeinde renoviert. Okay, great. Now let's see how to build a sentence in the passive voice. In English, you use the verb to be plus a past participle. Huh? The building is being renovated. In Luxembourgish, we use the verb gin plus the past participle. Now you must make sure to know the conjugation of the verb gin. In this video, I will go through the conjugation of the verb gin in the present tense, but in the transcription on my blog of this lesson, you can learn as well the conjugation in the imperfect tense. Okay, so let's start in the present tense to say ösch gin, okay, and then du gus, and pronounce it gus. Du gus. Hin hat gött. Mir gin. Dir git. And sie gin. Now let's learn how to build a passive voice sentence in the present perfect. So the past participle of gin is gin. Great. And then to build the present perfect, you need the auxiliary verb sin. And to build a whole sentence, you will then use your verb sin plus the past participle of your action verb and then gin at the very end of your sentence. For example, if you want to say the building has been renovated, you will say in Luxembourgish, Gebäude as renoviert gin. So as you can see, we have as, which is the verb sin, and then your past participle of the action verb, donc renoviert, and then gin. Gebäude as renoviert gin. Easy, isn't it? Now to conjugate intransitive verbs, which means verbs that take an indirect object, the passive voice is built with the verb kreieren in Luxembourgish. But this will be the subject of another lesson. Now let's put together all what you have learned. And what is very important is to make sure to use the correct tense of the verb gin when you want to build a passive voice. So if you want to build it in the present tense, in the imperfect tense, the present perfect, the future, or with a modal verb. So all this you will learn now with one example. And for all the examples, I will use the same subject, de cour. Okay? So, and as it is not important, and I don't know who is baking the cake, therefore we are in the passive voice. So for example, to say the cake is being baked. So this is present tense. How would you say this in Luxembourgish? So this is de cour gut gebak. So gut is the conjugated form of gin in the third person singular. De cour gut gebak. Great. Let's continue with the imperfect tense. How would you say the cake was baked yesterday? Yes, this is de cour gauf gösta gebak. Gauf is the imperfect tense of the verb gin in the third person singular. De cour gauf gösta gebak. And now let's use it in the present perfect. How would you say the cake has been baked on Wednesday? Yes, this is de cour as am Mittwoch gebak gin. De cour as am Mittwoch gebak gin. Now I hear you asking, but Anne, how do I know if I have to use the imperfect tense or the present perfect? Well, this doesn't matter. You can either use the imperfect tense or the present perfect. We don't make any difference. So you can say de cour gauf gösta gebak oder de cour as gösta gebak gin. For us, it's the same. Let's move on with the future tense. How would you say the cake will be baked tomorrow? Yes, this is de cour gut moer gebak. Remember that in Luxembourgish we don't have any future tense. So we stay in the present tense and we add an adverb of time. Here it is moer, which means tomorrow. So we say de cour gut moer gebak. Easy, isn't it? Learn now how to build a sentence in the passive voice with a modal verb. Let's take, for example, the modal verb müssen. Müssen to must, to have to. If you want to say the cake must be baked today, you will say, of course, de cour muss haut gebak gin. So you take your verb müssen, conjugate it. You add your past participle gebak, and at the very end of the sentence you put gin. De cour muss gebak gin. Easy, isn't it? Great. So now we will finish this lesson with an Übung, an exercise. So I will give you three sentences in the active voice and it's up to you to convert them into the passive voice. And I recommend to write your answers in the comment below so that I can give you my feedback. And don't forget that you can read the full transcript of this lesson with much more examples and much more sentences to translate from the active voice into the passive voice on my blog. And if you get a member of my blog, you can get access to a lot of free materials and a lot of free exercises. So, bist du bereit für die Übung? Dann lass! Satz Nummer 1, so sentence number 1. Den Doktor operiert mein Mom. So put this sentence into the passive voice and remember that in the passive voice, it is not important who is doing the action or we just don't know who is doing the action. Satz Nummer 2. Der Garagist fleckt mein Auto. Satz Nummer 3. Um Christmacht trinken viele Leute Glühwein. Great. Now I'm waiting for your answers in the comments below. And we will see each other in the next lesson. Merci fürs Zuschauen. Thank you for watching.